My name's John Pyle, and I'm an atmospheric scientist. I'm interested in the chemical composition of the atmosphere. What controls it? What changes it? How it affects the Earth system? The climate, if you like. The Montreal Protocol on substances that deplete the ozone layer is the most successful international environment treaty. Every country in the world has endorsed it. It's continually adjusted and modified based on scientific inputs. So every 4 years, we produce this scientific assessment for the Montreal Protocol. And I'm one of the four international co-chairs whose responsibility it is to assemble this document. To collect the evidence, we use complicated computer models. These have been developed using NERC funding. We build digital simulations of the atmosphere and the processes that control it.
In this lab, we develop novel instruments which we use to answer questions in various parts of the atmosphere. These measurements can then be used to help constrain the models and eventually to improve them. We have a new instrument here which is going to go to Borneo to measure isoprene emission from trees in a novel experiment where we're trying to make the atmospheric measurements at the same time as a wide range of biological ones.
We can then use the model to ask what if. So, what if we add or remove substances like the CFCs? And what are the consequences if ozone changes? After the discovery of the Antarctic ozone hole, we use these models to explain how ozone is removed from the atmosphere. So we demonstrated the large role that CFCs played, and also that the loss isn't just confined to Antarctica, but also happens in the Northern Hemisphere. We've also used our models to project how ozone might recover under the protocol, and to point out, crucially, what would have happened had there been no treaty. Ozone depletion has had a major impact on the atmosphere and was brought about by human actions which happened over only a few decades. If we hadn't had the protocol, a significant environmental and health disaster would have ensued.
It's vital that as scientists, we continue to monitor the success of what's already been done.
And it's absolutely crucial that scientists provide the underpinning knowledge on which politicians and businesses can base their decisions.